the Board of Trustees in the Islet Independent School District approved a new year-round calendar. There are two reasons why this recommendation was made and why the board ultimately decided to support the recommendation. There has been significant learning loss as a result of the COVID-19 pandemic. For many students, they have fell behind in mathematics and English. If we were to remain under our traditional calendar, students would report during the week of August 24th, nearly 6 months after the closure of our school district as a result of the pandemic. During that six-month period, we've made every effort, and we know that you as parents working with your students have made every effort to continue the learning. Unfortunately, without a structured and formal educational and instructional framework, many of these students have started to regress. This regression is commonly referred to as learning loss. To avoid learning loss, the Texas Education Agency has recommended and suggested that we look at a year-round calendar. It can be temporarily or it can be permanent, depending on circumstances and what the future holds, not just for our community, but for our state and our nation. Under a year-round calendar, students would be asked to attend school either in person or virtually. We are committed to providing parents and students with options. Notwithstanding, they would go to school for a 9-week period, and then there would be a 2-week break in October, the first 2 weeks of October. Students would return after the break and attend for 9 weeks before going on holiday or the traditional Christmas and New Year's Eve break. Students would return in January and attend for another 9 weeks before having another 2-week break in March. The spring break that we typically have and an added week, and then the schools would finish the school year with a final 9-week period. What's most important about this calendar is that during that 2-week break in October and that 2-week break in March, those students who we've determined have fallen behind, who are not performing at grade level, would be strongly encouraged to return to school during that 2-week intercession, where we can provide them with additional instruction, remediation, acceleration, enrichment, to make sure that they don't fall further behind and that they remain with their peers. This would happen in a smaller, more intimate, focused environment provided by only the top teachers in this school district. For other teachers and other students, the 2 weeks would give them an opportunity to take a step back from instruction and attending school and refresh, regain enthusiasm and effort before returning. When they return, again, another 9-week period of instruction followed by a holiday, another 9 week of instruction followed by a 2-week intercession in March, where students again would be identified and strongly encouraged to continue coming to school during that 2-week period. We know that there are going to be a lot of questions and concerns. This is, I'm sure, foreign to many people. It is a model much like the model that the Socorro Independent School District has had in place for decades, and it has been effective. I have no doubt that this will be an effective way to address learning loss and provide the flexibility and the possible adjustments we may have to make in the event that we have any COVID-19 cases surface at any one of the 58 schools district-wide that we operate. Please stay tuned for future announcements, as we are committed to making sure that we answer all of your questions and respond to all of your concerns. I want to thank you again for the patience and perseverance, the resilience that all of you have shown throughout this very, very difficult time for our community and for our school district.